extremely strung out on PCP at the time.
We profile a lot of terrible crimes on this show. There aren't many crimes worse than Gregory Tarkenton's. He decapitated a young mother with a machete. To make matters worse, he served less than a year of his sentence and then broke out of prison. Before we aired his profile last May, no one in Denver, Colorado had any idea the man they knew as a nurse's aide and student was really a convicted murderer. Philadelphia, October 20th, 1979. Police believe Melvin White and Gregory Tarkington were high on the drug PCP. White's estranged girlfriend walked in to retrieve her two-year-old son.
You chop my head off!
What are you talking about?
Chop my head off! I'm commanding you! Take your head off! Do it now! Do it now!
White and Tarkenton were both convicted of beheading Lynn Smith. Tarkenton got life and was sent to the Pennsylvania State Correctional Institution at Camp Hill. While inside, Tarkenton met up with Mark Young and Wendell Cherry, hatched an escape plan.
Tomorrow afternoon, man, we're set.
Young was captured, but Wendell Cherry and Gregory Tarkenton got away.
He told all of us in the class, the students and me, that he was trying to better himself and trying to get his life together.
I don't know, you feel betrayed. You're working with somebody and you try to take them on a gut level and try to be as honest as you can and hope that the individuals are being honest back.
Gil Romero, a homeless counselor, met Gregory Tarkenton on the streets of Denver 2 years ago. He knew him as Kevin Tarkenton, found him a bed at this transitional house, and helped him find employment.
The jobs he was working were janitorial. He worked as a production worker, making storm windows at a place, and then a couple positions as a nurse aide.
But Tarkenton had trouble holding down a steady job and drifted back and forth to the streets.
He would say, I know, I messed up. And I told him, well, you know, I'm not your mother. And at some point, you gotta do what you have to do.
So we need to find out what kinds of fluids they like.
Last month, Tarkenton landed a job at a nursing home. As part of his employment, he was required to take a nurse's aide course.
He was probably one of my better students, was doing very well liked. Sensitive and caring to the resident.
Friday, September 6th was a special day for Tarkenton, the last day of class, and a surprise birthday party for his teacher, Paula Gibbs. But FBI agents who'd been tracking him, thanks to one of your tips, broke up the festivities.
The FBI agents were there. They said, Kevin Tarkenton, or Greg Tarkenton, they said. And he just was silent and looked at the floor.
He did indicate that when he got up that particular morning, and he looked out at the sky and he smelled the air, that for some reason all he could think of was that it reminded him of Pennsylvania.
Tarkenton is being held on $1 million bail. While in jail, he talked with his nursing class teacher about his crime.
He said, Melvin and I were just two friends that were crazed out on drugs, and Melvin was in the process of having a nervous breakdown. And he said, I was so strung out on drugs, I couldn't tell that Melvin was giving me instructions that were totally off the wall. And he expressed regret over what he had done, but he also knows that it's very probable that he will be in jail the rest of his life.
Tonight, Tarkenton is in Denver's
Arapahoe County Jail.